What's better than a KX65? Well, four, of course. So I've been riding my KX65 so much that I decided to look for a spare bike when my main bike was down, or just to have something for friends to ride. Well, I found these three KX65s pretty close to me up in Paris, California, and I had to jump on the deal. It was absolutely a no-brainer. Two of the bikes are basically stock, and then one has a whole bunch of trick parts from R&D. There's the pipe, triple clamps, some hubs on the wheels, and I think the shock linkage is also R&D. I'm gonna go ahead and choose the R&D bike for my B bike. It's got the most trick parts on it, and I think it'll make a great platform for another supermoto. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tear this bike completely apart. I'm gonna look for any issues with the bike, and I also wanna make a parts list for anything that I need to pick up so that I can get this up and running as fast as possible. If you guys have any idea what kind of programmable ignition this is, please let me know in the comments. It has no markings on it and no discernible features. I'd love to know what this is before I run it. So now I'm left with a pile of dirty parts. This frame is absolutely disgusting. It's just caked with dirt and oil. I'm going to take this outside, I'm going to give it a good hose down, and I think I might actually paint it. I hit some of the plastics already, trying to peel as many stickers off. That was a nightmare. I'm going to get these parts as cleaned up as possible, and on the next one, we're going to be reassembling this bike. Thanks for hanging out with me in the garage, and I'll see you on the next one.